My guest this week is Andrew Hemingway, who's one of the three people running for state Republican Party chair in the elections next weekend. Andrew, thanks so much for coming in.
Of course. Good to be here.
So Republicans had kind of a tough election year in 2012. This is not a position a lot of people say, I really want this position. So either A, what's wrong with you? Or B, why do you want this job?
Well, I get a lot of those questions quite often, actually. I think that when you look at the Republican Party as it stands right now, sure, we were, you know, pretty badly beaten in the last election. I want this job because I believe that my skills and experience lend, you know, itself to the exact needs of what I've kind of identified are the problems with the party and what we've been doing. And I believe that I'm capable in leading the Republican Party through a series of changes and ultimately to victory.
You know, there are only 500 people that can vote in this election. And when we saw this election 2 years ago, it was a very clear choice between, say, Tea Party or more establishment or grassroots. What's the choice that folks watching this race will make a conclusion about?
Well, I think the choice in this election is much less about ideology or brand of Republican. It's much more about our ideas and, you know, our resumes. I've had the fortunate, ability to be able to run a grassroots statewide organization. I ran a presidential campaign. I've done digital fundraising. I have a digital consultant. I'm doing a lot of these things. And like I said, I'm kind of, you know, feel like I'm uniquely qualified for this position. And the choice in this election particularly is about ideas, about our background, and what sort of leadership we're going to bring to the party.
Great. Thanks so much for coming in. Now, you can follow more news about the race for state Republican chair at WMUR.com/political scoop. That's also where you can find an extended version of this interview. That does it here for TV. Now back to you. Well, we have a few more minutes here online. How is the race going? This is a hard slog, right? A lot of phone calls, a lot of meetings, just 500 people.
It's 500 people. You're calling
short
them.
Short campaign.
Calling. Yep. Yeah, that is actually the one really great thing, is that it is sort of a shorter campaign window. But I think it's going very well. I mean, look, I've laid out basically my vision, which is that we've got to improve on money, messaging, and mobilization. Technology underlies all of that in the revamping of where the party has to go. It's not a stepping away from the ideology or the platform or the issues. It's a rebranding. It's about talking. It's the way that we talk about the issues, to who we're talking about these issues to, that I think is where, you know, we ultimately have, you know, some of the issues, and I think we've got a great opportunity.
I've called around to a number of these folks who are going to be voting in this election, and the general sense that I get is, you're right, it's not about ideology right now. It's just fix it. I don't want to deal with it.
Yeah.
they saw a party that they elected a chair, Jack Kimball. Whether they liked him or they didn't like him, what they didn't like is all the drama that led to a coup, that led to him resigning, then having Wayne McDonald, had to take over the party. That was his role, vice chair, and they don't like losing, and they just want someone to take care of it. Is that the sense you're getting, or is there something else driving that kind of conversation?
Well, no, I think that there is definitely a sense of, we've got to get our act together.
Right.
I mean, I think most people recognize that we are probably at our, pretty low level as far as the state committee is concerned right now, and which I don't think is entirely true, but that's sort of the sense that's out there based upon just simply purely election
party
results.
Party registration. I mean, you guys are, it's parity, right?
Right. Yeah. So I think that we there are. I mean, and I do think that there's a ton of opportunity. I think that that the sense that I'm getting from the grassroots is that there are some very significant problems. We've got to change the way we're doing these things. We can't keep doing this the same way over and over and over again. I feel like this last election, what I'm hearing from people is, we just did the same things over that we've been doing for the last 10 years. It was the same style of campaign. There was no new technology introduced. There was no, updating of a database. We didn't change our style of election, of campaigning with the current times. And I think that's a positive for me. I think a lot of people see in me My technology background, the success that we had with the Republican Liberty Caucus and leading a statewide organization, people go, okay, he understands that this party has to be about the grassroots and that we have to have grassroots buy-in and that really ultimately our power comes from the grassroots. And he understands how to reach these people and mobilize them with a strong message through, the use of technology.
And where is this may be an unfair question, and so if you don't, I know this is on me, not on you, but where's the energy within the party right now? So, for example, a couple of years ago, you obviously saw a group of the Liberty folks really being passionate. Ron Paul getting 23% in the New Hampshire primary. I know you're with Gingrich, but you saw that drive and that passion, that side. Where is it, social conservative? Where's the passion inside the party now, the group that's really the one to watch, the subset?
I think that you have almost everybody activated right now. I mean, if you look at the New Hampshire House, you have... And the Republicans in the House right now, you have an amazing sort of breadth of all the little different types
little
of strands.
Factions.
Yeah.
Right.
Mm-hmm. I mean, you have them all there, and they're almost all in equal strength. Mm-hmm. And so I think, I don't think that there's necessarily one real, strand. And I think also that comes from losing.
Yeah.
I mean, when you lose, you're kind of, okay, let's look around, let's try and, reevaluate what we've been doing. I think when you win, there's a sense of like, okay, and people are, kind of pick different sides and stuff like that. So I really feel like there's a rallying. I think that there is a sense of people recognize we have to have the grassroots in order for us to be successful in 2014. Mm-hmm. And there is sort of this rallying of like, okay, listen, I'm willing to kind of maybe not be so harsh on this one issue if we can move this whole, our whole agenda forward. And ultimately that's, the goal of one of the goals that I have is to bring everybody to the table and say, look, what is it? Why are we Republican? What are those big things? And let's focus on those things and unite the party and move forward empowered by the grassroots.
There's also been a conversation within the party about whether or not the role of chairman should be paid. I mean, you got a young family.
I mean,
it's going to be a lot of time, very time consuming. How do you feel about that question?
Well, I mean, I think it's one that the committee members ultimately have to evaluate. I think that, my position would be, and I hope that Jennifer's is that I'm not going to institute or promote or ask for payment. Mm-hmm. I have a successful company. Mm-hmm. I've budgeted and planned and know that, I can do this job and continue to support my family. Mm-hmm. A lot of people have asked me that question, which I appreciate that they care about my family. But, obviously this
Well, it's obviously limited the number of people who can run for this position. Right.
Right. Mm-hmm. And I've, I've been successful and I have enough money in the bank to be able to support myself to do this. Mm-hmm. And so it's not something that I'm going to be pushing or promoting or even, would accept. I mean, I think if the state committee said, hey, we're going to pay you, let's have that conversation. But I think there's probably some better ways that we can spend, the $25,000 that you probably pay me, to do things to actually win.
Right. Thank you so much for coming in.
Of course.
And thank you for watching WMUR.com.